Second one in this. Tollens test. Which test? Tollens test. Ammonical silver nitrate. Ammonical silver nitrate. Ammonical silver nitrate is commonly known as Tollens reagent. Ammonical silver nitrate is commonly known as what? Tollens reagent. Okay, ammonical silver nitrate is commonly known as Tollens reagent. Means when ammonium hydroxide dissolve in silver nitrate solution, it forms a complex AgNH3, taking two times here is OH. Okay, here is what? Positive charge or R. Ag NH3 taken two times, here positive charge, then here is what? NO3 minus. So this particular complex is known as Tollens reagent. Which reagent? Tollens reagent. Generally it can act as a mild oxidizing agent. It is a mild oxidizing agent. Mild oxidizing agent. When an aldehyde reacts with Tollens reagent, TR. TR means what? Tollens reagent. Tollens reagent followed by heating. R C double bond O, here is O minus plus metallic silver is formed. In Tollens reagent, the oxidation state of silver is plus 1. Now it converts into which one? 0. So oxidation number is 0, plus 1 to 0. So that is the reason why this is reduction. So the species which is involved in reduction can act as what? Oxidant or oxidizing agent. So to form which one? Metallic silver. So it is silver mirror PPT. Which PPT? Silver mirror PPT precipitate is formed. Now any aliphatic aldehyde, any aliphatic aldehydes are heated with Tollens reagent. The walls of the test tube, silver mirror PPT is obtained, or silver mirror layer is obtained. In this case, ionic silver converts into which one? Metallic silver. And aldehyde converts into which one? Acid. Aldehyde converts into which one? Acid. For example, acetaldehyde, react with Tollens reagent followed by heating, it forms CH3C double bond O, O minus. Next one is which PPT? Metallic silver. This is which one? Silver mirror PPT. Silver mirror precipitate is obtained. Based on the formation of this silver mirror precipitate, Aldehydes are identified in the laboratory. Which are identified? Aldehydes are distinguished. Now, benzaldehyde. Generally, aromatic aldehydes do not give tollens test, but this benzaldehyde gives benzoate ion and which one? Metallic silver, approximately how much percentage? 10%. Okay, na? So therefore, only in aromatic aldehydes, benzaldehyde will give how much percentage? 10% of tollens test. So this is one of the good test to distinguish aliphatic aldehydes as well as aromatic aldehydes. Okay, the very very important point here, ketones do not give tollens test. Ketones do not give tollens test. So aldehydes are differentiated from ketones. For example, in a given mixture acetaldehyde and acetone is there. In a given mixture, both acetaldehyde and acetone is there. The suitable test to distinguish this particular mixture is tollens test. Positive tollens test is given by acetaldehyde, but acetone is a ketone, it do not give which one? Tollens test. It cannot give silver mirror precipitate, which PPT, silver mirror precipitate. So that is the reason why ketones never gives tollens test. Only aliphatic aldehydes are give this particular test. Okay, so like this, aldehydes are differentiated from ketones. So like this way, aldehydes are differentiated from which one? Ketones. Failings test. There are two types of failings solution. One is failings A, another one is what? Failings B. There are two types of failing solutions. First one is failings A is aqueous copper sulfate. Then failings B is Rocelli salt means aqueous copper sulfate and sodium potassium tartrate. This is known as Rocelli salt with alkaline copper sulfate solution. Now failings A plus B is always gives which one? Failings solution. Which solution? Failings solution. Now when aldehyde, it is also a mild oxidizing agent. FR means what? Failings solution, followed by heating, it is converts into C double bond O minus. Aldehyde converts into an acid, then it forms cuprous oxide. Which oxide? cuprous oxide, it is a red color PPET. Earlier is which PPET? Silver mirror PPET. So right now which PPET we are obtaining? While using failing solution, red color precipitate. In this case, copper plus 2. Copper plus 2 converts into which one? Copper plus. It convert into what? Us. Cube. Okay. Copper plus 2. Cupric converts into which one? Cuprous. So that is the reason why this is reduction process. So therefore, it can act as what? A oxidizing agent. So now, a carbonyl compound, especially an aldehyde, react with Fehling's reagent to form carboxylate ion as well as what? Cuprous oxide. It is which PPT? Red PPT. So, Tollens reagent and Fehling's reagent. Somewhat, Fehling's reagent is weak oxidizing agent. So, that is the reason why it never react with aromatic aldehydes. It is also one of the distinguished test of aldehydes from ketones, but only aliphatic aldehydes will give this particular test, but not aromatic aldehydes. For example, third one is haloform test. What is that? Haloform test. CHBr3, known as bromoform. This is brown color PPET. Brown PPET. CHI3, known as iodoform. Iodoform. This is which color PPET? Yellow color precipitate. Which precipitate? Yellow color precipitate. Now, when a carbonyl compound, especially there is a proper skeleton is required to give positive alloform reaction. To give positive alloform reaction, a carbonyl compound compulsory contain methyl ketonic group. With respect to keto group, the adjacent compulsory CH3 group is required. With respect to keto group, next carbon compulsory 3 hydrogens are required. The next carbon contains compulsory 3 hydrogens are required. A keto group, the next carbon compulsory contains how many hydrogens? 3 hydrogens are required. Now, CH3, C double bond O like this. This is the keto group or a carbonyl group. The next carbon compulsory contains how many hydrogens? 3 hydrogens are required. This type of skeleton containing known as alpha methyl. This is which one? Alpha. Because this is a functional group. The functional group adjacent to carbon is alpha. So known as alpha methyl. Alpha methyl ketonic group. This is the standard skeleton to show haloform reaction. To show which one? Haloform reaction. So methyl ketonic group containing every carbonyl compound. Every carbonyl compound, it may be aldehyde or ketone. Every carbonyl compound gives which one? Positive haloform reaction. The reagent is halogen in presence of base. We are using here what? Halogen in presence of a base. If you are using bromine in presence of a base, known as bromoform, it is brown color precipitate. If you are using iodine in presence of a base to form, what is that? Iodoform reaction. Which reaction? Iodoform reaction. So this is the basic skeleton is required to show which one? Methyl ketonic structure, especially from a carbonyl compound. Now, for example, if I am taking here is R, C double bond O, then here is what? CH3. Now it has a methyl ketonic structure. So definitely it reacts with, for example, iodine I am taking. It reacts with iodine, 3 moles of iodine plus 4 moles of base, that is sodium hydroxide, followed by heating. Rupture of carbon takes place here. This alpha carbon rupture takes place. So now it is converts into CH3. Now it is converts into CHI3 as a yellow precipitate, yellow PPT. It is known as iodoform. It is known as what? Iodoform plus R C double bond O minus, here is what? Na plus. What is that? Not Na plus? Yeah, Na plus. So therefore, now this on hydrolysis, H plus, now it converts into which one? An acid. So therefore, in every alloform reaction, a rupture of carbon takes place from alpha methyl carbon. Which carbon? Alpha methyl carbon. So rupture always takes place here. So therefore, converts into two products. So like this, alpha methyl group containing carbonyl compounds are distinguished from alpha methyl group containing carbonyl compounds are distinguished by using which one? Alloform reaction. C double bond O, here is what? CH3. 3 moles of iodine, 4 moles of sodium hydroxide. It forms R C double bond O N A plus C H I 3. This is known as iodoform. What is this? Iodoform. If when we go for the mechanism of this one, is mechanism, here is R C double bond O CH, here is what? Hydrogen CH2. Now first, which is added? A base is added. This base abstract a proton from hydrogen. Now like this, first loss of water molecule takes place here. R C double bond O, here is what? CH2 minus. This reacts with iodine molecule. It comes here, loss of which one? I minus. So this I minus and Na plus. Loss of sodium iodide here. Loss of sodium iodide. Here is what? 3 moles of sodium iodide is lost. This is the complete balanced equation. Now, loss of sodium iodide here, because first sodium hydroxide dissociates into Na plus OH minus. So 1 mole of OH minus is added, loss of water molecule takes place. Okay, then this I minus iodine react with this one, loss of sodium iodide takes place to form R C double bond O. It is what? CH2I. Now, the second step, it is also again react with abstract a proton. Now, again loss of water molecule takes place. R C double bond O CH negative charge, then iodine. This again react with another mole of iodine, Now it will attack on this loss of which one? I minus. Again loss of which one? Sodium iodide. C double bond O. Here is iodine, then here is which one? H. So now 2 moles of water molecule is lost, 2 moles of which is lost? Sodium iodide is lost. Again which is added? A base is added, because minus I groups are increases, proton releasing capacity increases. So therefore R C double bond O I, here is I, then like this. 3. Now it forms which one? A carbon anion. Loss of again water molecule. Now it again react with which one? A iodine molecule. Loss of which one? Sodium iodide. So now it forms R C double bond O iodine. Here is also iodine, like this. Now the rupture of carbon takes place. The reason is 3 minus I groups. Iodine can act as what? A stronger minus I groups. So that is the reason why, in presence of basic medium, if you are using a base, immediately this base comes here, rupture of this takes place here. Rupture of this particular carbon takes place here. Now it is converts into C minus Ci3 plus R. Here is C double bond O, here is OH. Immediately this proton is abstracted from this one. Okay. So now it converts into R C double bond O O Na plus, what is this? CHI3. This is which PPT? Yellow color PPT. Which PPT? Yellow color precipitate. So like this way, how many moles of water molecule is liberated? Here is 1 mole, here is 2nd mole, then here is also what? 3rd mole. So therefore 3 moles of water. How many moles of water? 3 moles of water. How many moles of sodium iodide is liberated? 1 mole of sodium iodide, 2nd mole of sodium iodide, then 3rd mole of sodium iodide. How many moles of base is involved? The first mole, okay, here is 2nd mole, then 3rd mole, here is what? 4th mole. So therefore 4 moles of which is involved? A base is involved in this particular reaction. How many moles of iodine is involved? Here 1 mole, 2nd mole, then here is what? 3rd mole. So this is the overall iodoform reaction. Which reaction? Overall iodoform reaction.